Welcome to STG Kids Online. My name is Laura Grace, and I'm so glad you're here with us today. If you're joining us for the first time, welcome! Before Kate introduces our story, let's remind ourselves of this week's big picture question. How is Jesus the perfect prophet? The answer? Jesus perfectly reveals God the Father and fulfills what the prophets spoke. I can't wait to hear what our Bible story is going to be. But before we do, let's sing a song. If you want, you can stand up with me and sing. We love to sing songs of praise to God because He is loving, merciful, patient, and good.
Hello friends, my name is Kate and I am so glad that you are here to do Sunday school with us online. I wish you could be here in person with me at St. George's, but I'm so glad to know that you are there and at home watching. All right, have you ever gone traveling? Have you ever traveled far? Maybe to a different state or even to a different country? Yeah, some of you? Well, I lived in France, I've lived in England, I've lived in a lot of different states that are far from here in Tennessee. But sometimes it was great, sometimes it was scary, or I didn't understand the language, but I always learned a lot. For those of you who have traveled, what was it like? Was it scary? Was it fun? Yeah? Well, traveling is a great way to learn about the world, and God created the cultures of different people, all of whom are loved by God. And it's wonderful to be able to experience and get to know those different places and cultures. But it can also be great to come back home after being away. And that was especially true for the Jews who'd been forced to live far away from their homes for 70 years. So before we begin, let's remember our big picture question. How is Jesus the perfect prophet? Does anyone remember the answer? That's right. Jesus perfectly reveals God the Father and fulfills what the prophets spoke. That means that Jesus' words, thoughts, and actions were exactly in line with God the Father. Because Jesus is God's Son, he has all power and authority. Every prophecy in the Old Testament led to Jesus, and all of God's promises will come true in Jesus. So let's watch our story video now to find out how it tells us about our perfect prophet, Jesus.
Many years before God's people were taken to Babylon, God promised the prophet Jeremiah that the exile would last 70 years. Then, God would bring his people back home. God always keeps his promises. Cyrus, king of Persia, had taken over Babylon. God gave Cyrus an idea. Cyrus said, "Let all of God's people go back to Jerusalem so they can rebuild the Lord's temple. Give them gold and silver and animals. Give them gifts for God's temple." The exile was over. God's people were free to go back to their homes. God's people got ready and their neighbors gave them gifts. Silver, gold, and animals, and other expensive things. Zerubbabel and the high priest led God's people back to Judah. They had been away for 70 years. Many of the people were born in Babylon. They had never seen the land God had given their parents and grandparents. In all, thousands of people went back to Judah. They settled in their hometowns and set up their houses. Then the people met together in Jerusalem to rebuild the Lord's temple. First, the priest rebuilt the altar in the same place it used to be. They followed all the laws of God for building. When the altar was finished, they offered burnt offerings to God. The people also obeyed the law about special celebrations. They had a festival like God had told them to do, and they made sacrifices to God. Then God's people gave money to stonecutters and carpenters who would work on God's temple. They paid people to bring cedar logs to Jerusalem. Finally, when everything was ready, the people started to work. They laid the foundation of the temple. The foundation was important. It would make the building strong. When the foundation was finished, the priests put on special clothes and the people praised God. They sang, "The Lord is good. His faithful love will last forever." Then the people shouted and praised God. They were so happy. The foundation of the temple was complete. Not everyone was happy, though. Some of the older people remembered what the temple had looked like 70 years ago, before it had been destroyed. They cried. The noise of the crying and shouting was so loud that the people could be heard far away. Zerubbabel led God's people back to the temple to rebuild it. The temple was the place where God met with his people on earth. Jesus came to earth to rescue God's people. One day, Jesus will return to restore a greater home for all of God's people, and we will spend eternity with him.
God's people had gone through some pretty rough times during their exile in Babylon. Do you think God had forgotten about them? No way. God never stopped loving his children. They were his chosen people, and he had long ago promised that he would never abandon them. In fact, God had been using their time in exile to glorify himself and bless the world. Many kings and people who did not know God saw firsthand his power and his love for his people. God had told his people through prophets like Ezekiel and Jeremiah that the exile would not last forever. When God makes a promise, you can believe that he will keep it. God kept his promise to bring his people home. The Bible tells us the Lord roused the spirit of King Cyrus to allow the people to return to Israel. Clearly, God was at work and in total control. He knows all things and has the power to make anything happen that he wants. King Cyrus even demanded that the people of Babylon give silver and gold, livestock, and other valuables to the Israelites. And as a result, they had the money and materials they needed to begin rebuilding the temple and their homes. God provides for his people always. And sometimes he provides in surprising ways. One day, Jesus will return to restore a greater home for all of God's people, and we will spend an eternity with him. Let's thank God in prayer now.
Let us pray. Dear God, thank you for loving us. Thank you for always having a plan for us to bring us home to you and to have new life with you. Please help us to trust you. Please be with everyone who is tired, sick, lonely, or afraid. Please give them hope, love, and comfort. In Jesus' name, amen.
Thank you so much for praying for us. God is so good. Now we're ready to do our memory verse. Last week, we started a new memory verse from the book of Jeremiah, chapter 29, verse 11. It says, "I know the plans I have for you. This is the Lord's declaration. Plans for your well-being, not for disaster, to give you a future and a hope." If you want to, you can stand up and move around with me while we sing the song to help us remember.
Plans I have for you. This is the Lord's declaration. Plans for your well-being, not for disaster, to give you a future and a hope. To give you a future and a hope.
If you'd like to, you can go and grab your pack from church that will have supplies for this week's craft in it. And you can do it while you are watching the video or after. Enjoy.
Hello, we're so excited to have you back for the craft for January 31st. This craft reminds us about how God brought his people back home to Jerusalem. We're going to be making a house sun catcher.
So the first step that you're gonna wanna do is pull out all your supplies. You're gonna wanna put some glue down on one piece of the parchment paper. You can use a paintbrush, your finger, or even a Q-tip to spread it out. If you have a tricky glue bottle like us, you might need to take the top off and get your paintbrush or Q-tip to get it out. Because our next step after we get the glue spread out is we are going to start laying down all those pretty little pieces of tissue paper. Because these are going to make the fun part of our sun catcher. So you can lay them out however you want, just get them in really stuck into the glue. Perfect. All right, then your next step is you're gonna put even more glue on top of that tissue paper. When you think you have enough glue on top just to keep the black strips of paper stuck to it, you can lay out your black strips in the shape of a house. So we have one for the bottom, one for the side, one for the other side, and then the last two pieces are going to be your roof. Perfect. All right, so those are all stuck together to make our house outline. And now we are going to put, yes, even more glue on this house. I'm going to cover it up because then we're gonna need the next piece of parchment paper to stick on top of it. It's gonna sandwich it all together. And maybe you have in your pack, maybe you have parchment paper like us, that's one big piece, or you might have two separate pieces. But the second piece is going to be the top piece of bread for our little sandwich of house. Okay, so then we are going to smooth this next piece of parchment paper over top, just like this. Awesome, all stuck together. And then we can cut out the excess parchment paper. And lo and behold, we have a little house sun catcher to hang up in the window to remind us of how good God is, that he brings his people out of exile and back to their home.
Thank you, and we'll see you next week.
Hi again, everyone. I'm so glad you were able to join us this week. Remember, if you want to do any of the activity sheets or the craft, you can do them right now if you grab your pack from church. We hope to see you again next week. And remember, you are so loved. Bye!